Dr. Walid Juffali's appointment as St. Lucia's permanent representative to the International Maritime Organization has gathered a lot of criticism from some members of the public. The controversy took a different angle with news that the UK has called on the government to waive the diplomatic immunity of the ambassador. Earl Huntley weighs in on the matter.
In the case of Juffali, if she's asking for monetary compensation or a greater amount, then the government will have, then there will have to be a request to the government of St. Lucia to waive his immunity to allow that matter to be heard. If she's only asking for property, then the government does not even have to grant any waiver because he can be taken to court on that matter. Now, I understand that there is a letter from the chief of protocol or the head of protocol from the Foreign and Commonwealth Office, which I find strange. That this is a letter from the chief of protocol to the acting high commissioner and not a diplomatic note, which is from the Foreign Office to the high commission, which is normally the standard practice in those things.
The request was made by the legal firm representing the ex-wife of Dr. Juffali, who was being called upon to answer a claim for additional financial relief in the High Court in London from his ex-wife, whom he had divorced in Saudi Arabia.
Almost all the cases that have come up against diplomats for alimony or for compensation, they have not succeeded because of the diplomat's immunity.
Okay. Right. We
but I don't understand. I mean, I can. Obviously, the thing is being made a political football to try to embarrass the government. The opposition has been talking about it, and people have been saying there can be serious repercussions if you don't waive. And that's why I was saying it's a lot of fuss about nothing, because in the first case, if she's asking for property, there's nothing to be waived. Okay, if she's asking for money, then that's another matter.
A statement issued by the government indicated that St. Lucia enjoys close political and diplomatic ties with the United Kingdom and will therefore follow the well-established diplomatic channels to address this matter while protecting St. Lucia's integrity as a sovereign state. For the DBS News World, I am Sarah Peter.